We want to solve the rational inequality and express the solution using interval notation. The first step is to write the inequality as a quotient on the left and zero on the right. This indicates the first step is to subtract 9 on both sides, which gives us 5 divided by the quantity x minus 4 minus 9, which I'll write as minus 9 divided by 1 is less than or equal to 0. And now we still need a single quotient on the left, and therefore we have to subtract. Notice to subtract, we need to obtain the least common denominator, which we can see is the quantity x minus 4, which indicates we multiply 9 divided by 1 by the quantity x minus 4 divided by the quantity x minus 4. Notice now we have a common denominator of x minus 4. We now have 5 minus 9 times the quantity x minus 4 all divided by the quantity x minus 4, less than or equal to 0. Final step is to simplify the numerator. Notice the numerator is 5 minus 9x plus 36, which simplifies to 41 minus 9x. We can now write the inequality as 41 minus 9x divided by the quantity x minus 4, less than or equal to 0. Step 2, we now determine the zeros of the numerator and denominator by setting the numerator and denominator equal to 0 and then solving for x. For the numerator, we have 41 minus 9x equals 0. Let's go ahead and add 9x to both sides, which gives us 41 equals 9x. Divide both sides by 9, and we have x equals 41 ninths. Let's go ahead and record this in the table below. And now we find the zero of the denominator by setting x minus 4 equal to 0. Solving for x, we add 4 to both sides, and we have x equals 4. Now that we have the zeros of the numerator and denominator, we plot the zeros on the number line. The zeros of the numerator, which in our case is 41 ninths, will be plotted as an open or closed point based upon the inequality. The zero of the denominator is always plotted as an open point. To begin, notice 41 ninths is more than 4 because 36 ninths would be equal to 4. So let's plot 4 on the left as an open point because this is where we have division by 0, and division by 0 is always undefined. When x equals 41 ninths, the numerator is equal to 0, the denominator is non-zero, which means the fraction is equal to 0, and because the inequality is less than or equal to, because 0 is less than or equal to 0, we make a closed point on 41 ninths. This indicates 41 ninths is a value that does satisfy the inequality. Now, if the inequality was just less than, not less than or equal to, then we'd have an open point at 41 ninths. And after the last step, we need to test each interval to see whether it satisfies the inequality. We can either use the original inequality or the inequality in this form here, where we compare to 0. It's much easier to compare to 0, so we'll use this form of the inequality to perform the test. Let's go ahead and pick our test values. On the left, let's use x equals 0. On the right, let's go ahead and use x equals 5. I know 5 is greater than 41 ninths because 45 ninths would be equal to 5. And then we need a value between 4 and 41 ninths. Let's use 40 ninths. So we could use a calculator or by hand calculate the exact values of the quotients on the left, but really because we're comparing to 0, as long as we determine whether the quotient is positive or negative, we can determine whether the inequality is true or false. So let's first test x equals 0. Again, we're using this inequality to perform the test. Notice when x is equal to 0, the numerator is 41 or positive. The denominator is negative. And a positive divided by a negative is always negative. A negative value does satisfy the inequality because a negative value will always be less than or equal to 0, which indicates the interval on the left is true and is going to be part of our solution. And now we'll test 40 ninths, which seems like it may be challenging, but I think we can still reason out the sign of the numerator and the sign of the denominator. Notice in the numerator we have 41 minus 9 times 49ths. The 9s will simplify out, and we have 41 minus 40, which is positive, divided by, remember 49ths is more than 4, so a positive value more than 4 minus 4 is still going to be positive. A positive divided by a positive will always be positive. A positive value is never going to be less than or equal to 0. The interval in the middle is false. For the final test, we need to test x equals 5. When x equals 5, the numerator is going to be 41 minus 9 times 5, or 41 minus 45, which is negative. The denominator is going to be 5 minus 4, which is positive. A negative divided by a positive is negative. A negative is always less than or equal to 0, and therefore the interval on the right is true. Notice the interval on the left and the interval on the right are the solutions to the inequality. Let's first state the solution using inequalities. The interval on the left, this interval here, is x less than 4. Or the interval on the right is x greater than or equal to 41 ninths. Again, our directions do say to use interval notation. So remember, on the left we approach negative infinity. On the right we approach positive infinity, which indicates using interval notation, we express the solution as the open interval from negative infinity to positive 4. Remember, we use an open parenthesis to the right of 4 because 4 is not in the interval. Union, on the right we have the interval from 41 ninths to infinity. The interval is closed on 41 ninths, or includes 41 ninths, and therefore we use a square bracket on the left and an open parenthesis on the right. This is the form of the solution the question asks for using interval notation. I hope you found this helpful.